Well, here we are with another animation experiment, this time using EbSynth. I've learned quite a lot about animation since I've started messing with it. My initial foray into this was the SDCN animation extension for Stable Diffusion, which produced, let's say, mixed results. So I went back to the drawing board and started messing with other techniques. At first, I started with just batch image-to-image processing, which produced a lot of flicker. And then I started messing with EbSynth, which is basically a tool that takes in a keyframe and extrapolates from that point. And while this is very good at producing consistency across time, it has its limitations. It's not able to invent stuff that's not there. So it struggles with anything that has a high amount of motion. So then I started thinking, okay, how can I balance EbSynth's ability to smooth out frames and Image-to-Image's ability to make new frames? And can I blend them together in a way that's better than automated animation utilities like SDCN Animation? And again, I produced mixed results. I'll let you be the judge on whether or not these are better or worse than the other animations I've made previously. They all have their drawbacks, and they all look weird in their own unique way. So, some of this might just be up to personal preference of aesthetics. I'll also add that this technique requires a lot of improvising, so somebody else who does the same thing is gonna get wildly different results than I am, because we're probably gonna select different keyframes that look good to us and blend them in different ways. Alright, let's get into the nitty-gritty of how I did this. Step 1, take your video and divide it up into individual shots. Every time the camera changes, you're gonna have to divide that up into its own shot. Then you take that individual shot and you export every frame into a PNG sequence. I use FFmpeg to do this. Your fancy editing tool might be able to do it, but I'm using all open source tools. FFmpeg's pretty easy. Next, you're gonna wanna go to Image to Image in Stable Diffusion and pick a frame and start refining your prompt to look as good as possible on just one single frame. And after you have a satisfactory prompt, you're gonna want to lock down the randomized seed and keep all the same settings so that you can apply them to every single keyframe moving forward. You wanna do this so that you can minimize the differences between the frames. There's still gonna be a ton of flicker, but the idea here is to minimize it as much as possible. Oh, and another thing you're gonna wanna optimize is the denoising strength. So, the lower denoising strength means that it resembles the original image more. This is a fight between how much liberty Stable Diffusion has to recreate the image and how much it's gonna be consistent with the original. So in other words, if you have a really low denoising strength, that flicker is gonna be really low, but also, it's not going to have enough creative liberty to transform it into a new character. So that's a balance you're going to have to strike. Next, you've got a couple options here. Option 1 is to just brute force it and run it through a batch and process every single frame. This is a time-consuming process. Maybe you kick this off and just walk away.
Just walk away.
Go to bed or whatever and come back when it's done. Option 2 is to handpick every keyframe and do everyone individually. This is a lot more of a manual process, but if you only have a few keyframes to do, this is probably the way to do it. And a good rule of thumb on whether or not to handpick the frames or just brute force them all is how much motion is in the shot. How much is the character moving? How much is the camera orbiting the character? If there's a lot of motion, then you're gonna want a lot more keyframes. But if the character is just standing still and moving their mouth or whatever, then you could get away with maybe as low as just one keyframe. So keep that in mind. Now, after all the keyframes are generated, this is where the real labor-intensive part comes in. Now, I'm aware that there's an EbSynth extension for Stable Diffusion. I have not used that. I am manually putting things into EbSynth right now, manually processing all of its outputs. I'm sure there's better workflows out there. I'm just learning this stuff as I'm going. So what you're gonna wanna do is look at all of your keyframes that got generated and select the very best ones by hand. The good thing about generating them in a batch, if you did that, is that now you have the luxury of picking the very best ones, the survival of the fittest, if you will. After you use this for a little bit, you're going to kind of intuitively pick up on when Absinthe will break down in its frame extrapolation. So after a little bit of practice, you're going to get better at picking out how many keyframes go into Absinthe. The next thing you're going to want to do is make a new output directory for Absinthe for every single keyframe that it processes. What you're doing here is you're making a new video for every single keyframe. And the optimal way to do this is to have it process from the previous keyframe through the current keyframe to the next keyframe. So let's say you start at keyframe 1, your next keyframe is at 8, then you process from 1 to 8, and then the next one processes from 1 to 8 to, let's say, 16. And then your next keyframe is at 16, and it processes from 8 to 16 to 24, and so on. This might make a little bit more sense when I show you how I blend all of these shots in. But yeah, to put it another way, you are overlapping Absinthe's extrapolation from keyframe to keyframe. And again, for the most consistent results, you're going to want to minimize the number of keyframes. But it's just something you're going to have to get a feel for as you use Absinthe. Okay, this next step, I have a feeling somebody out there who knows more about video editing than me is screaming and saying, "No, what are you doing? Don't do that. Do it this way." But I'm going to show you just kind of a brute force way that I learned with KadenLive, which is an open source video editor. I don't have Adobe After Effects or anything, so I'm just kind of brute forcing my way through this thing. So basically what I do is I take all my clips in, I overlap them with the original video, and then I just crossfade in between every single clip. That's it. It's just a simple wipe from one clip to the next one. And that's what produces that kind of trippy morphing effect. The next clip, which is based off of a totally different stable diffusion output, is fading in just as the previous one is fading out. And, that's it. That's the secret. The rest is just hard work, getting used to tweaking your stable diffusion keyframes and tweaking which keyframe is going to be best in Absinthe. That's all there is to it. So, yeah. That's pretty much all I have for today. I hope you learned something. This is just one of many different techniques for animating with stable diffusion. So maybe you pick aspects that you like, adapt them to other workflows, whatever. I'm just here to document what I'm doing in the hopes that somebody else will learn from it. So thank you for watching and have a nice day.
I feel my tendrils rising. Higher, higher, it's winding through in my soul. Girl, 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 you're pouring sand in me on fire. My brain is flaming, and I don't know which way to go. Girl, you're casting the living night. Sweet song all the whiteness, like my morning sky, I'm burning up. I feel my temperature rising. Help me, I'm flaming, but what's the amount of night? Fine, burning, and nothing to throw me. I just might turn to smoke, but I feel fine. Oh, you're getting a little higher, like the swimming song all the way. And you like my Lord.